Hey, and welcome to the remote studios. I built this a while ago for intros, and as you can see, I've used car pads for the walls. I get it, people like walls. So let's do some walls today. I've used counters up top for a hedge with a pop of color using a rug. Let's move on out. Now you can use a simple frame to jazz up your wall. I've used koa with walnut center. And then over here, the ever-present oak and elm. Again, it looks slightly nicer with the frame. And we'll slide into this mini studio. And you can see where I've pulled in some design elements from the main studio. Large floor, regular floor, small floor. You know, some simple squares. And it really makes the interior look different and nice. Now we'll slide over to the last mini studio. And I've just gone with stripes of koa and walnut. It's a much more somber look. But again, it still adds something to the walls. Now I built some demo walls for this. And they're inset in the ground. You can certainly pop those up if you want symmetry. And I built them 4 units out. That way you can build out from your wall or add design elements up top. So that's merely a large floor and a regular floor, and then I've alternated, and you can repeat that all the way down. Simple but effective. Over here I've done diamonds, with a smaller diamond on top of a larger diamond. Gives you that nice effect, some 3D. Here I've done an inset, and then some medium diamonds, and a small diamond. Now there's gonna be a bit of math involved. Ratios are important. This is a 2-4 wedge, so half of that is a 1-2. Now you need to put in the larger elements first, in this case the big medium diamonds here, and then you can put the small diamonds inside of those. Now we've got some simple stripes here, but they certainly bring a lot to just a plain walnut wall. I've done this on my pub crawl base. And stripes are awesome and easy to do. So just get some contrast. And as you can see, they're still hard to climb, so no one's coming over. Of course, that's a simple design, but you can get as busy as you want. And here I've just done vertical squares for diamonds. Again, ratios. This is a 4x4 wedge. You put the big elements in first, and then you cut it down in half, and the small diamonds will be a 2x2 wedge. And just insert those in your gaps. And then over here, I've added what stripes might look like at your front door or a corner. You can angle them down, and it's a sharp look. If you put those with the stripes on the other side, easy, simple, and we'll get lots of looks. So as you can see, I've recently expanded this remote location base. It used to just be the mini studios and the truck. So I'm gonna start using this base to do larger builds. I did wanna come back and look at these at night. I've got these backlit in the floor right out of my lighting video. And you can see the designs pick up the light and really makes your walls look dynamic at night. All right, well, I hope some of these walls have given you ideas about what to do with your own base. And we'll see you again next time. Thank you so much.